Previously on South Beach Tow.
How did you write to me on the internet if you don't speak English? I'm just gonna text her one more time.
If the girl wanna go on a second date with you, she'll let you know.
You've got to be kidding me.
Is there like big land and stuff, you know, where he could run free?
Come on, you guys are Tremont Towing. You guys are the biggest.
To run a successful repo business, you need a secure lot and a tow truck. You in or you out?
And right now.
Yo, Robbie, we're good?
You are dragging a bomb through the streets of Miami.
You look awfully nice. You dressing up for me?
The girl you keep talking to over the internet is a fake.
All right, let's do this.
Hey, Perez, what did you do, man? Oh.
Robbie and Perez building a business together. Nobody's gonna see that coming.
Dude, I'm glad you're all enthusiastic about all this. It just feels really weird to me.
We got our own truck, we got our own lot. We're not even breaking any rules, man.
And I swore to my sister there would be no more secrets.
I'm sure you could use the extra cash.
You're right, you're right.
I am right.
Bro, what the hell is that?
It's the hydraulic boom. It keeps dragging on the ground. Everything's gonna be fine. Don't worry about it.
This is it?
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah, baby. One down and four to go.
That was pretty easy.
Tell me about it.
All right, Dave, I gotta hop on there.
Let me just finish up this email here.
Hi, Mary Elise, you heard back from her?
No.
You know he didn't hear back from her. He sent so many text messages, email, and voicemails, she probably already filed for a restraining order.
Whatever, I've moved on. I mean, Mary Elise was nice, but this connection I have with Chloe Cutie 83, it's on a whole other level.
Who, the swimsuit model with the duck face?
Baby, look here. Finally, the fashion show is over with. We should have a nice romantic weekend together. I made a reservation for us down to the Keys.
I do need a vacation, but I really want to go to ATL to visit my family and my friends. I was planning on leaving tomorrow.
Well, maybe I could come with you.
I really need to get centered, but the only way I could do that is by myself.
How long are you gonna be gone for?
Probably about 2 weeks.
Actually, I was thinking, I hope you would get a job again, baby. Baby, no disrespect, but your fashion show taking all my money.
You mean our money. Don't get it twisted.
Fine.
And you best behave while I'm gone.
We're looking for a Dodge Caravan. Guy's supposedly storing it in a lot right here.
Bro, this looks sketchy, bro.
It's right here. Come on, come on, come on, come on.
Oh, man,
you gotta
bro.
Be gentle, bro. Come on, go, go, pull out, pull out, pull out. Okay, go, go.
Let's go.
You gotta make it right here. That's two for two, baby.
All right, what's next?
Hello?
I'll be with you in just a second.
Can I just have my change so I can leave, please?
Hold on 1 second.
Excuse me, miss.
Yes,
hi.
Ma'am.
I'm just waiting for my change, and he's just texting.
Dave, what are you doing? Give the lady her change.
All right, if you'll just step out that door.
Oh, thanks.
I don't know what's going on with you right now, but customers are our number one priority. You know this.
Tremont.
Hey, it's Kathy from Felix Hernandez's office. He was supposed to stop by Tremont tomorrow afternoon and sit down with Christie. Is she available?
Yes, she is.
How about 4 p.m.?
Sounds good.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you. Isn't he that land developer?
Yeah. It's just weird that he would want to come by the tow yard.
There it goes right there. Dodge.
Get out. Check the van.
Yo, what are you doing? Stop. What are you doing?
Are you Derek Rogers, sir?
Yeah, what is going on here?
Listen, you're 3 months behind on your payments, and we're here to repossess the vehicle.
Dude, come on. This is my work truck. I do business out of this vehicle. At least let me get my equipment out of the back. I have a gig tonight.
Sir, you're not allowed to take anything from the vehicle. You have to speak to your bank.
I have $2,000 worth of explosives in the back.
Explosives?
Yes, fireworks. A rig to go off in the back of my truck.
Yo, Robbie, we're good?
Yeah, go ahead, little bit.
No,
easy.
Gently. Hey, be gentle. What are you doing?
Hey, relax. Easy as that. Hey,
seriously?
You know what I'm doing. Don't worry about
There's fireworks in there, bro. Let's go ahead and unload it, bro.
You know how this goes. Get in the truck.
Please.
Let's roll, bro. Come on.
Look, the entire undercarriage is scraped. You are dragging a bomb through the streets of Miami.
Dude, slow down, man. You heard the guy, man. There's fireworks back there, bro.
Robbie, people will say anything to get out of a repossession, all right?
Bro, just be careful.
Fine, fine.
Bro, slow down. Slow down. Dude, take it easy.
Bro, I know what I'm doing, all right? You ready to go get that neon?
Let me inspect the truck first.
Come on, baby, let's go, bro.
I smell gas, bro, really strong.
Are you serious?
Oh, man, the truck's leaking gas, man.
Oh,
go ahead, pull up. Hey, stop. You're dragging the boom, the gas. Hey, go, Brad, go. Man, Perez, what did you do, man?
Oh, my God, bro.
Oh, man.
Oh, no. Hey, stop. You're dragging the boom, the gas. Hey, go. Perez, go. Man, Perez, what did you do, man?
Oh, my God, bro.
Whoa! Robbie, the van is on fire!
Oh, no!
Oh! Whoa! We gotta save the Acura! Oh, my God! What are we gonna do, Robbie?
Morning, Dave.
Morning.
Some funny chuckles?
I'm texting with Chloe Cutie 83.
You know, Dave, I was hoping you'll come to the realization yourselves, but since you ain't got no common sense at all, let me break it down for you. The girl you keep talking to over the internet is a fake.
What? Why would somebody lie on the internet?
Dog, it's plenty of scammers out there willing to hustle lonely-ass men like you. Dave, you ain't send this girl no money, did you?
I sent her a little bit.
How much?
Well, like $1,500.
Dave!
She's working as a volunteer at the Children's Hospital. They were gonna evict her from her apartment. They were even gonna turn off her phone.
Dog, I'm not gonna let no scammer take all your damn paper.
Well, what do you propose we do about this, Bernice?
The address, where you sent the money. You still got it?
Good morning.
Morning, Christy.
What's going on?
Bernice is convinced that Chloe QD83 is some kind of cyber fraud.
I mean, I didn't want to be the one to tell you.
Man, come on, Dave. Let's blow the lid off this show.
Yep. Ain't no handicap pass on this car.
Yo, what are you doing, man? What you doing?
Yo, man, listen, if this is your car, man, you park here in a handicap spot without a handicap permit. You want it back, it's gonna be $115 here,
or 250 back at Tremont.
But look, man, I really needed to park here, man.
Why would you need to park in a handicap spot, dude?
Be honest with you, man, I got a serious problem.
I don't need to hear all that, man.
All right, man, well, I applied for the handicap permit, but they turned me down.
That's why you're gonna pay $115 for your car.
You're a thief, man. You ain't nothing but a low-life thief.
Listen, there's no need to get up in my face, dog, and popping off on each other, man. I ain't angry, dude. I'm only feeling sadness and despair for you right now. It's just depressing to me, knowing that you parking in a handicap space. It's just not right.
You're getting way too deep on me.
You know what, bro? I could really use sun and lift my spirits right around now.
Hey, Robbie, what's up?
A little tired.
Listen, I know last night was kind of a disaster and all. I'm gonna deal with the insurance company so we're covered, but I got a fresh batch of repos in today and I sent the truck in for repairs. I mean, that's if you're down.
I think this was a sign that this is a really bad idea.
Come on, man, that was a freak accident. And I know you need the money.
Yeah, you're right, I do need the money. But I don't think I need it that badly.
All right, whatever, man.
Not a problem at all.
Mm-hmm. Hey, I'm gonna clock in, okay?
All right, bye-bye. What's going on? Robbie looks like he's been through the ringer lately. Maybe it's time to mend fences. I know, things have been really rocky between us since Dad promoted me. Don't get me wrong, I blame you 100%. But I also, in hindsight, realize that I've been really rough on you. So I'm sorry.
You ain't gotta apologize. I know a lot of it was my fault, you know? Totally screwed up, so.
So we're good?
Yeah, we're cool. But you know, we'd be even cooler if you forgave my debt to the company.
Robbie, you took commission for repos that should have gone to the company.
Why can't you forgive the debt? You're my family.
And I'm also your boss, and I gotta keep the two separate.
I don't know what is crappier. You as a boss, or you as my sister?
Robbie!
Hey, Christie.
Hey, what's going on?
I'm here finishing up the paperwork on the horse, and I needed you to sign some paperwork for me.
All right, come around. I'll let you inside, okay?
Okay, thank you.
Is this really necessary?
Yes, it is, Dave. The whole thing is costing you money. It's time to face the truth.
You could be wrong.
Dave, I believe there's a woman out there for you. I really do. But she's not a 30-year-old swimsuit model / pediatrician who runs a nonprofit organization for kittens. The Venezuelan shown you didn't speak no English, she was perfect.
She never called me back.
Fine, whatever. Time to man up.
All right, let's do this. Maybe nobody's home.
I hear somebody coming out the back door, dog. Somebody coming out the back door, dog.
Oh, my God.
Well, well, well.
You better tell me the truth right now. Are you Chloe QD83?
In the flesh.
Oh, my God.
So sorry, Dave.
I hope you like what you see.
What the hell are you doing, man?
You repoed my car. I'm guessing this is revenge. Next time, don't put all your personal information online.
I sent you money. What you did is illegal.
Sue me. I'm insolvent.
I cannot deal with this right now. I'm sorry.
Dave! So you just think you're gonna get away with it?
You have no recourse. No lawyers, no police, no recourse. Now get in your truck and get the hell out of here.
Man, I'm Bernice. I don't need no lawyer, no police, or nothing. That's right. Lock your door. Y'all saw that? He touched me first. I'm coming back tomorrow and you bust out that money Dave gave you. Trust me.
It's of the horse is gonna be okay?
Yeah, the horse will be fine. I think the owner's gonna be in jail for quite a time now, but it's okay. We have Lady Palm Nursery down in Kendall to adopt him.
So that's all you need from
me? That is all I need.
Thank you again.
Oh, no problem. You could call me for anything, Christy.
You know I will.
Okay.
Bye, honey.
Bye.
Brandis, what you doing here?
Some paperwork.
You look awfully nice, dressing up for me.
No.
Don't lie.
Don't try to get me in trouble, because I know your wife's somewhere in one of these cars looking at us right now.
Nah, she went out of town.
And left you here by yourself?
Yup.
In the middle of nowhere. Lady Palm right here, Liz. Wow, that's a nice place, man.
Hey, did you guys take in a horse named Tecumseh?
Yeah.
You did? All right, thank you.
You're welcome.
Look at the piggies. Hey. God, you guys stink, bro. Oh, we got roosters up in here. Look at this. This is what I'm talking about, man. Hey. Look what I found. Oh, God, look at you. You're so cuddly. There goes my baby. Tecumseh, how you been? You know what, bro? I spent a lot of money on therapy, but being here, this makes me feel right.
Let's do this, buddy.
It's you and me against the world, buddy. You know what I mean? Let's go, Tecumseh. You know what, bro? Maybe out here in the country is where I belong.
Yeah, we was dating a couple of weeks, but it wasn't nothing serious. He was always trying to make me pay for his dinner. I had to dump his ass.
Damn, girl, I wouldn't have done you like that.
I know, but it's a lot of scrubs in this city, I'm telling you. I gotta admit, I wish you were serious about me like you were about Wanda.
The time wasn't right, baby.
Yeah, I guess timing is everything, right? I guess I should go now. I got a few more appointments to make.
All right. It wasn't like that, man.
I should be going for real now.
Yeah.
Damn. Hey, Dave, what are you doing?
What does it look like?
Don't do that. You've been making so much progress.
It doesn't make any difference, Bernice. I'm never gonna find love.
You're gonna make yourself sick.
The struggle is real.
Give me that.
Now, what's wrong with you?
Give me that. Damn, Dave, what are you doing? Dave, that is nasty.
Excuse me. My name is Felix Hernandez. I'm here to see Christie.
Hey, Christie, Mr. Hernandez is here to see you.
How are you? It's been a minute.
My pleasure. You have an interesting group of characters here.
They are a colorful bunch. Have a seat.
What brings you down here? Isn't the South Point project going up now?
Yes, it is. I'm heading over there right now, but wanted to congratulate you on your quarterly revenues.
Thank you. It's been really crazy around here lately.
Yeah. Well, I am very interested in expanding my business ventures.
Isn't
the South Point project going up now?
Well, I am very interested in expanding my business ventures. You know, when I first moved to Miami, I never realized that the towing business could be so lucrative.
So you want to buy out Tremont? Seriously?
How can I help you?
David!
Mary Elise!
Traté de llamarte, pero no me pude comunicar contigo porque se me cayó el teléfono en el toilet.
I don't
understand a word you're saying. 1 minute.
Does anybody here speak Spanish? Perez, come here. I need you right away.
What's going on?
It's Mary Elise. She's back, but she doesn't understand a word.
What the
English.
Hell? What happened in here?
Just,
what is
just
this?
Just translate for me. Just translate.
David, tuve un tiempo maravilloso contigo.
Dave, she says she had a wonderful time with you.
Traté de llamarte, pero se me cayó el teléfono en el toilet.
She said that she tried to call you, but she dropped her phone in the toilet.
Oh, my.
No tenía forma de comunicarme contigo.
She had no way of getting in contact with you, Dave.
Dave, perdóname. Me encantaría volver a salir contigo otra vez.
¿Tú estás seguro? Este tipo es un desastre. So please forgive her that she would love to go out with you again.
Yes, I would love to go on a second date.
Do you even know what the towing business entails?
All I know is it's a very lucrative business.
This is a family business. It's been in the family for years.
And you're always talking about me eavesdropping.
We get offers here and there.
How big are the offers?
Not big enough.
Big enough to retire?
I mean, it would take a lot of money for me to consider retirement. This is a lot of money.